That beautiful baby has already been through a lot in his short life, and that's not even the half of it. His name is Jaden, and his fight to survive began before he was even born, when a tumor was pushing his heart to the other side of his little chest. After Jaden was born, doctors still had their hands full. They were trying to tackle a tumor, the likes of which they had never seen. Tonight, Kent's going to explain how they did it and how Jaden and his parents persevered.
Don't be fooled by Jaden Merville Beeman's cool demeanor.
He just likes chilling.
This six-month-old has the heart of a fighter.
He is the strongest baby.
He is.
I know. He is a trooper, our little warrior. Yeah.
That is something Samaya Merville first discovered when she was just 29 weeks into her pregnancy, when one day she couldn't feel Jaden move.
We went to the movies that night. I did what they call a sweet test, so I ate some candy and had some pop, and I laid back in the recliner seats, and I still didn't feel him move. I told Eddie, just take me straight to the hospital.
The severe swelling doctors quickly discovered on this 3D ultrasound was a symptom of the strain on his heart.
The fluid in him wasn't flowing properly because of the tumor.
This is how big the tumor was.
The clear mass on this 3D model shows just how much little Jaden was up against.
More than two-thirds of the chest is occupied by the mass.
Even at 29 weeks it was?
Yep.
Had you seen a tumor like this before?
No, I started the fetal cardiac program, so I pretty much know what are the patients that are coming in for the past 25 years, and I have not seen a tumor this big.
Dr. Shanti Narasimhan says the first step for her team at mHealth Fairview's Masonic Children's Hospital was to relieve that swelling.
They drained the fluid out of him and me. Really, the objective was keep him safe in my tummy for as long as possible.
But then, at just 32 weeks, Jaden was tired of waiting.
I remember thinking on my way to the hospital was like, him being born is one thing today, but then we still have like that tumor to address, you know?
They said they may even have to do comfort care. They were saying, we don't really know what's gonna happen when he comes out. He may not breathe once he's born. We don't know what's gonna happen until it happens. I was scared.
Her little warrior survived day one, and after a CT scan on day two.
Here's Jaden's heart.
Dr. Narasimhan got to work.
The blue was all his tumor.
Deploying a brand new, virtually untested virtual reality program in order to better understand something she'd never encountered.
Oh, I can actually go inside the chest cavity and then actually pinpoint where the tumor was attached to. So that's what we did.
And just hours before surgery.
Here's the aorta.
She discovered something critical.
It was attached right there.
The tumor wasn't attached to critical structures in the heart, dramatically increasing Jaden's outlook.
Did you feel like you could trust what you were seeing?
I did trust this VR segmentation for this patient, yes. I actually told the whole team that the pulmonary veins were not involved within this tumor mass.
I didn't even realize they were using that kind of technology.
The heart should be sitting on the left side of the chest.
I just knew it was very intensive though, like I knew it was serious.
And not long after, she knew the surgery was a resounding success.
It was really crazy just seeing his journey from having so many breathing tubes and feeding tubes.
Now it's mommy's time.
6 months later, Jaden does have one lasting reminder of that battle.
Look how good it's healing. Oh my gosh.
This guy has me surprised. I don't even know how an adult would tolerate what he had.
Our miracle baby. Jaden's doing good, I'm doing good.
Yes, indeed.
And the army behind her little warrior has a lasting reminder too.
You just rolled this out?
Yep.
It seems like it was kind of meant to be.
Yes, exactly.
Do you know how strong you are, Jaden?
You're a special boy, man.
Jaden's parents say they are beyond grateful, of course, for his entire care team in addition to that technology. That team, of course, helping keep him alive before, during, and after birth and that surgery. Samaya is also grateful she followed her instinct during pregnancy when she didn't feel Jaden moving. Had she not, he likely wouldn't have survived, her doctors told her.
Man, you just think of all of the hurdles they had to clear, get the right doctor who was just so focused on she could do it, she could do it. But props to that kid. I can't wait to see who he becomes.
He is chill and so alert.
Well, he's been
it's
through
like
it.
He knows.
In the womb, out the womb. He's like, give me a minute.
Just so special.
Technology for good.
Yeah.
Thanks so much, Kent. We appreciate it.